everybody. This is Leanne. And I suppose you know that during the month of July, we have a sermon series called Heroes and Sheroes of the Bible. And so for those of you who can't be here on a Sunday morning, I didn't want you to miss the story of the hero or the shero of the Bible. And so I'm going to send out this little video each week to you that you can watch, and then you'll know what the story is. So anyway, our story for this week, the hero of the Bible, is a guy named Joshua. And it's found in the Bible, in the book of Joshua, chapter 5. So Joshua was Moses' helper. And Joshua had help, too, from a woman named Rahab. And that's what the sermon is about. But for us, I just thought I would tell you the story of Joshua, because he was a hero, too. So was Rahab. So anyway, Joshua was told by God that he could take the people into the promised land. But when they got there, there were other people living there. And God said to Joshua, "Joshua, this land belongs to you. It doesn't belong to those people. They're going to have to leave and know that you are the person that's going to live in the promised land." And so God said, "Joshua, take a trumpet and march around the city with your army 7 times. And on the 7th day, blow your horn, and those walls will come tumbling down." So Joshua did what God said. He got his trumpet, but he didn't use a trumpet. He used this. This is a shofar. It's a ram's horn, and you can blow it. And I have this in my office, and one of these days when you're at church, come in my office, and I'll let you try to blow this. So anyway, Joshua marched around the city of Jericho for 7 days, and then on the 7th day, he blew his shofar. Now, it's hard to blow. Let me try. That's what it kind of sounds like. I'm not a very good shofar blower. But anyway, he blew his trumpet and those walls came tumbling down. He is a hero of the Bible, and he reminds us that when we do what God asks us to do, even if it sounds crazy, like marching around a city 7 times and then blowing a ram's horn, that God is good to us and God keeps God's promises. So I'm thinking that maybe for a little activity for you today or this week, you could look for things that blow. Like, I bet you don't have a ram's horn laying around your house, but maybe you do. But there's other things you can use. So, like, you can use a piece of paper and you can roll it up like a horn and you can blow through it. Do, do, do. And when you blow it, you can remember about the hero Joshua, and you can remember that God keeps God's promises and that everything is possible with God. You know what's a really fun thing to do too? Take a piece of grass. Have you ever done this? And you put it between your thumbs like this. You stretch it tight. This is just grass that you pick outside in your yard. You put it between your thumbs and you blow. Let me see if I can do this. Oh, I can't get it to blow. Hold on. Let me try it one more time. Okay, hold on. Here we go. Like that. Did you hear it? You can make a little trumpet out of a piece of grass. You can use anything in your house that you want to use to blow a prayer to God. But when you do it, I want you to find something, a ram's horn, a piece of paper, some grass. Blow away. And then you know what? Thank God for being so amazing. Make a joyful noise like Joshua did and see what happens. Have a great week. I'll see you next week with another hero. Bye.